Aaron, what are you going to read today?
I'm going to read To Tiger by S.J. Four.
Read To Tiger by S.J. Four. Okay, that's a good one.
I sit down on my couch and open my book. It's time to read. But I can't read because there's a tiger behind my couch. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Chewing gum. Tiger. I shake my head. Please spit out your gum. I want to read my book. And I can't think when you chomp. Oops. Tiger is saying, tiger won't chomp. The tiger says, but I can't read my book because I hear, I can't read my book because there's a tiger behind my couch pretending to be a bear. Tiger, please take off my bear's costume right now. You're going to rip it. And will you please stop growling? I tell the tiger, I can't concentrate. Can you see I'm trying to read? Oops. Tiger is saying, tiger won't be a bear anymore. The tiger takes off my bear costume and stops growling. I pick up my book again and try to read. But it's very hard to read when there's a tiger, a cry tiger. Hi-ya! 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 Behind your couch.
Wow.
Tiger, stop! Now isn't a good time to work on the karate kicks. I want to read my book. Oops. Tiger is very tired. Tiger won't do karate kicks. No more karate talks. Tiger, stop lying. I try to read, but coming around my couch. Choo 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 choo. There's a tiger riding my toy train and blowing a whistle. Tiger. Get off that train right now. Stop tootling. I want to read. Can you be quiet? I think that's my book.
Great book, Aaron.
It's not? What book is it? Oops. Tiger is very sorry. Tiger can be quiet. The tiger says, the tiger stops chittering and stops tootling. I try to read my book again. Suddenly, crack, creak, crack, creak, crack, creak, creak, crack, creak, crack, creak, crack. The couch is flying up in the air because there's a tiger under it. Tiger, put me down! What in the world are you doing? Under my couch? The tiger is looking for the whistle. The tiger lost it. The tiger sniffles. I help the tiger find the whistle. Then I say, "Tiger, please sit down right here and be very, very quiet so I can read my book, okay?" "Okay, Tiger will stop, will sit down. Tiger will be very, very, very quiet." The tiger whispers. The tiger plops down on the floor in front of me, and he is very, very quiet. He doesn't make another sound, no chomping, no gurgling, no yawning, no chewing, no chew-chew-tooting, not even a creak cracking. I hold my book up in front of my face so I can't see the tiger. I try to concentrate. All of a sudden, I think I see a little shadow on my book. I do see the shadow. I think I see a whisker. I do see a whisker. Then I see a nose and a whole tiger in front of my book. "Tiger! What are you doing? You're in the way. I can't see my book. I'm trying to read." "What's that?" the tiger asks. The tiger points to a picture in my book. "A tiger! That's the tiger in the story," I tell him. "A tiger!" the tiger shouts. Then he jumps onto the couch. He fluffs to the couch cushions and curls up beside me. And finally, I can read my book to Tiger.
"Great job, Aaron. That was a great book. Read to Tiger. Thank you for this story, Aaron."
"You're welcome."
Alrighty, off to school you go. It's always good to read a book before school. And off he goes.